wait.
I can't wait too.
Mommy's amazing adventure game has started.
Yay!
Hello, everyone. Welcome to my amazing adventure game.
Elmo is so excited to find out what amazing adventure our friends are going on today.
Today, Tendai, Lily, Zuzu and Moshe are going on an amazing animal adventure!
Yay! Yay!
Here's how the amazing animal adventure works, ne? First, I'll roll the color cube. And then you must go to the flag that's the same color as the color cube. I put a picture of an animal on each flag.
Huh?
And you have to pretend to be that animal on your way to the flag.
You. I hope I don't land on an elephant. I don't even know how to make an elephant sound. I don't think I'll be a good elephant.
Yeah. Let's do this.
Zuzu, you're up first.
Woohoo! I have to pretend to be a frog on my way to the green flag. Ribbit! Ribbit!
Yep. Oh, did you know that there are more than 5,000 different types of frogs in the world?
Sweet!
Ribbit! Ribbit! Ribbit!
Next up is Lily.
Great! Lily gets to be a bird.
Did you know that a group of birds is called a flock?
Tweet! Tweet! Tweet!
Tweet! Go, Lily!
Go, Lily!
Go, Lily!
Oh, yes!
You.
Moshe!
Hey!
Wanna go next?
Tendai, can you please go first? Please?
Sure. Moshe's speaking so quietly. I hope he's okay.
Yeah, me too.
Green, I'm going to be a frog with Zuzu.
Zuzu! Oh, yes! Go, you little frog.
Ribbit. Yes, yes! Ribbit. Go to that!
Ribbit! Ribbit! Ribbit!
Your turn now, Moshe.
You. Please don't land on elephant. Please don't land on the elephant.
Blue, that's the elephant.
You.
Hey, Elmo. I think Moshe is having a big feeling. Oh, shame. See how he's dropped his head, eh? I think he might be feeling unhappy about something. Yo, Moshe. Is it okay if we talk about the big feeling that you are having?
I can't make an elephant sound, and it's making me feel heavy inside.
I understand, Moshe.
I stopped playing because I felt like being alone.
Thank you for letting me come talk to you about your big feeling, because it's helped me understand that you're feeling sad.
Yeah, I'm feeling very sad, Zikwe. You're right.
It's okay to feel sad, eh? We all feel sad sometimes.
All of us.
Moshe, Would you like to try draw it out?
Well, I guess I can try, Zigri.
Oh, great, Moshe. Mm. Great.
I felt sad that I couldn't do an elephant sound. And then the cube landed on blue, and I didn't want to play anymore. Mm-mm. But
talking to Zigri really helped me feel less sad. Yeah.
Gummy's game is really fun, no matter what. It makes me feel warm and sunny inside. Yeah. Hey, you know, I think that helped. I don't feel so sad anymore.
Ah, wonderful, Moshakes. You know, drawing it out is one great way to help when you are having a big feeling. Moshe, do you think you are ready to play again?
Yeah, I think I can try, Sikwe.
Kornanovs!
Gummy.
Yebo?
Gummy, I'm ready now.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I felt sad because I couldn't make the elephant sound.
Yeah.
But drawing it out helped me feel much better. Yeah.
Oh, that's so great, yeah. Moshe. Okay, let's do this. Are you ready?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Please be the elephant. Please be the elephant. Yay! It's an elephant!
Yay!
Let's go, Moshe!
Coming! Hi!
It's just Moshe!
Oh! Obviously, I knew that!
Wow! Moshe! You make a great elephant sound! That was great! You...
Yeah, yeah.
Did you know that the elephant is one of the heaviest animals in the whole world? Yeah, Elmo taught me. He knows a lot about things that are heavy.
Welcome to Elmo and Zoe's Math Adventures.
Today, Elmo and Zoe are learning about...
Wait! Oh, hi. You're just in time to play our guessing game. It's called What's Heavier Than a Mango?
Oh, boy, that sounds fun. Can we play?
Sure, Cookie Monster. And now we need...
Let me guess, something heavier than mango.
No.
Nope.
Me no think so.
Thinks this watermelon might be
heavier than a mango?
Yeah, but how can we tell?
Me think we need to find its weight.
When something's heavy, it weighs a lot. Weighs a lot. Yeah, it weighs a lot. When something's heavy, it weighs a lot. Weighs a lot.
Did somebody say something about weight? I, your fuzzy friend Grover, know a lot about weight. Today, we shall weigh my chicken friend, Bodybuilder Chicken. She works out. Let us see if Bodybuilder Chicken weighs more than this bag of sand.
Oh boy, that looked like it weighed a lot.
Yes, but as you can see, Bodybuilder Chicken's side is still lower. So that means she does weigh more than this bag of sand. But your clever and cuddly pal Grover has an idea. You see, Bodybuilder Chicken weighs the same as one bag of sand and one relaxed Grover. Thank you, Bodybuilder Chicken. Let us see what else we can learn about weight. Follow me to the next door. Hello again. Do you want to know more about weight? I knew you did. That is why Bodybuilder Chicken has this stick. And I have two, count them, two baskets. In this basket, I will put one, two, three, four, five feathers. And in this basket, I will put one, two, three, four, five rocks. Now, I will simply put this right here on this end, and... Boy, this basket of rocks is heavy! Whoa! Oopsies. Correct! Even though each basket has five things inside, they weigh differently. Five rocks weigh more than five feathers. High five? Okay, maybe later.
Elmo's having fun learning about weight.
Aha! I, Grover, will show you more about weight. But first, it is feeding time for my little chicken friends.
Yes.
Turtle will be here any moment now when you start. Any moment now. Okay, chickens. I will go see what is taking Turtle so long. Ah, Turtle, here you are. The chickens are very excited for their snack.
Sorry I'm late, Grover, but this bucket of delicious chicken snacks is hard to carry. It weighs a lot.
Do not worry, my friend. I will show you how to make this heavy bucket lighter. I will just take some chicken feed out of this yellow bucket and put it over here in this blue bucket. Do not worry, chickens, we are coming! Okay, Turtle, now this yellow bucket is light enough for you to carry.
Yeah, it's lighter because it's empty. What do I feed the chickens now?
I took all the feed out of the yellow bucket and put it into the blue bucket. The chickens are getting very loud. Ah, I, Grover, have an idea. Okay, Turtle, now you can feed the chickens.
Oh, here you go.
You are welcome. Thank you, Turtle, and thank you, chickens, for helping us learn about weight. Bye-bye.
Wow, now we really know a lot about weight.
And now we can figure out what's heavier than a mango.
Oh, me have idea.
So we learned something new about math. Now it's helping us play in a brand new.
Chat with Basma and Tiamo.
So, Tiamo, tell me a little bit about sharing. What does sharing mean?
Sharing means if you have something and your other friend doesn't have it, you give them some of yours or you just give the whole thing to them. And that's sharing.
Yeah. So it's kind of like, you know, this one time I went over and I played with my best friend, Judd. I think you've met Judd, haven't you?
Yes.
Yes. And we were playing so much the whole day and we were running around and we were doing cartwheels. You know, I just learned how to do cartwheels.
Wow.
So cool. And then by the end of the day, I was so hungry. And then Judd had apple slices that his mommy had packed for him. And he shared like half of his apple slices with me.
That's so kind.
Yeah, so that's what sharing means, right?
Yeah.
Aw, that was very sweet of him because I was very hungry. My tummy was going... I was very hungry. Sharing, caring, and being kind are my three favorite things in the world. Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
Now you do.
I love to share.
Sharing is kind. It's why I share something of mine.
I love to share.
Good to give some care and love and you receive.
I love to share.
Come on, man.
Love. I love to share. I love to share.
Someone said, one kind word can make them glad.
I love to share. I love to share. With you. Sharing with you.
The game is starting. Come.
Are you ready for this, Moshe?
Ah, big time, Susie. Yeah.
Ooh, it's starting.
Welcome to the quiz, Fabulous Finding Game. Hi, guys. Here we go. Today, you have to find this ball. This ball. Can you see it? Okay. I'm going to hide it without actually hiding it.
That is impossible.
Hey, Elmo, your old pal Zigwe is a master of the impossible, eh? Just yesterday, guys, eh? Mm-hmm. I kissed my own elbow and counted every single piece of my fur. Okay. I'm going to hide this ball, in plain sight. It won't be inside or behind anything. Just look very closely, eh? Very closely, and you'll find it.
Okay.
Yeah, so here we go. No picking.
Oh,
my picking.
Krishnan,
no picking.
Elmo.
Elmo's not looking.
Okay. Let the games begin!
Yeah!
Where could that ball be? Wrong ball.
Wow, Gummy's trying so hard because she really wants to find the ball. Look how focused she is.
So focused.
Yeah.
Cornelops!
Well done, Elmo!
I am so impressed with how hard Gummy is trying. Go, Gummy!
Gummy's trying so hard that she didn't even hear you, Moshe.
She's very determined to find the ball.
Moshe?
Eh?
What does determined mean?
When you feel determined to do something, all you want to do is keep trying until you do it. Yeah, right now, Gummy is determined to find the ball.
Not under the table. Maybe in here. Yeah.
Okay.
Where's the ball? Have you seen it?
No.
We found it!
I can't believe we found it. Let's go.
They found it!
I know I can find the ball. I know I can do it.
Zigwe, I didn't see you there.
Gummy?
Yeah, Zigwe?
Would you like me to give you a clue to help you find the ball?
No, thanks. I really want to find it by myself.
Gummy?
Yes, Zigwe?
It looks like you're having a big feeling, eh?
Yeah, I think I am. My heart feels fluttery, but I don't want to stop till I find that ball.
Yeah, that means you are determined to find the ball.
That's exactly what I'm feeling. I'm feeling determined. It feels so good, but sure, so hard to stay determined.
Yeah.
Gummy, Dad and I learned a great way to help us stay determined.
Yes.
Pretending to stand tall, eh? Like a tree. Really, really helped Basma and Cookie Monster stay determined, eh?
Yeah.
Gummy.
Yes, Zigwe?
Do you want to try being a tree too?
I really want to keep looking for the ball, Zigwe. But, okay, I'll try being a tree.
Great! Yay! Do it with us! Yeah, yeah Mushakes! Huckfrey start! Take it away!
Okay, let's all be a tree together. Start by standing tall with your feet a little bit apart. Stay strong and still. Now that we're planted on the ground, like the roots of a tree, let's take a slow, deep breath in and stretch our arms out wide, reaching out like the branches of a tree. And slowly breathe out as we bring our arms back down.
Oh.
Sure. Zikwe, that felt so good. I'm feeling much calmer now, and I'm even more determined to find that ball. Okay? Here I go. You don't do it, Gabby! Not in here. Not in there.
Amazing! Well done for staying determined, Kami.
Oh, thanks, Zikwe.
In the next round,
yeah?
I'm going to hide this broom. Yeah, bo. Okay, you'll have to look very carefully because the broom is narrow. Can you see?
Yeah.
Okay, and you won't see it when I hide it behind something that is wide.
Wow.
Okay, no peeking.
Okay, no peeking.
No peeking.
No peeking.
Okay, let the games begin. Lazo.
Zikwe said he hid the broom behind something really wide. But this is really narrow.
Let's look around and choose the widest thing we can find, ne? Then look behind that.
Great idea, Kami.
Yeah.
That's not wide.
No.
That's not wide.
That is wide.
No, not sure.
We found it, Zikwe.
Yay!
Congratulations,
eh? Yes.
Yeah, Elmo.
Please, can Elmo show our friends all the other wide things that Elmo knows about?
Sure, Elmo. Let's see what Elmo learned about things that are wide.
Welcome to Elmo and Zoe's Math Adventures.
Today we're learning about
Flip.
Snack time. You can sit with me, Basma. What? Something seems off here, and I think it's me.
Sorry about that. Here, let me scoot over.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's not quite right either.
Elmo is starting to think there isn't enough room for both Basma and Zoe on the bench.
And I'm starting to think you're right, Elmo. The problem has to do with the bench's width.
The who's or what's it now?
Well, the width of the bench is the distance from one side to the other. Get it? You don't get it. That's okay. I know a song about width.
Width is how long something is. From side to side, yeah, side to side. Width is how long something is. From one side to another.
Did someone say width? It is I, Grover, here with some friendly Grover math. I know a lot about width.
Hi, Grover. Hi, Mazooza.
I like to measure the width of things from fingertip to fingertip, like so. Grover is measuring you. You see, this right here is the width of the box. And look over here. Grover is measuring you.
That's the width of the table.
And here is the width of Mazooza's stick. Now I will show you another cool thing about width. Width is very interesting because... Mazooza, could you please be quiet for just a moment while I explain? Thank you. Now, different things have different widths, and we can measure them. Mazooza, do you think you could stop mine just a little longer?
Grover, Mazooza won't stop.
I have an idea. Mazooza, Fetch! You can use almost anything to measure with. A string, a stick, or even a fancy ruler. I like to use my feet because I always have them with me. Watch as I measure this planter. I start at this side, and I walk all the way to the other side, counting. One Grover foot, two Grover feet, three Grover feet. So this planter is 3 Grover feet wide. What about this planter? Let us measure its width together.
One Grover foot, two Grover feet, three Grover feet, 4 Grover feet.
The width is 4 Grover feet.
Correctamundo.
Elmo thinks the width of this planter is greater than the width of that one.
That is correct, little Elmo. 4 Grover feet is larger than 3 Grover feet. Follow me for another neat thing about width. Come on!
Wow! Grover really knows how to measure width.
We're learning all about width, about width, about width, yeah, about width. We're learning so much about width.
Mazuza won't make it through the gate while she holds that stick in her mouth.
Exactly. Why? Because the width of the stick is greater than the width of the gate opening.
Oh, I get it.
So there is no way that Mazuza can get through the gate.
Wait, look! Mazuza is chewing the ends of the stick.
Now the stick's width is less.
Which means it's small enough to fit through the gate.
Whoa! Well, that concludes our chat about width.
Thanks, Grover. Now we know exactly how to fix our bench problem.
So we learned something new about math. Now it's helping us play in a brand new way. We learned about
width. About width.
About width.
About width.
About width.
About width.
About width.
About width. Yeah!
Elmo thinks this new bench is the perfect width for both Zoe and Basma to sit on.
No! Mazuza! We need a wider bench.
Welcome to Chit Chat with Basma and Ratti.
Ratti, you know, it's very easy to do nice things for your friends, but have you ever done something nice for someone in your class, maybe? Maybe you saw someone who was a little bit shy or who wasn't feeling okay, who was a little bit sad. Is there anything nice you did for them?
There was one time we all had to read to the whole class, and then my friend Zara went up, and then she was shy to read, and everybody was laughing at her, and then I said, keep quiet. After that, I told her to start reading, and then she started reading, and then at the end, I told everybody to clap, and then everybody clapped, and then she thanked me after.
Aww, Ratti, that's so sweet. You know, it's really nice when you have friends like you, Ratti, who take care of you and who stand up for you. It's really nice. Who taught you how to be so kind? Your mommy and your daddy.
I just try to be kind most of the time because if I'm kind to other people, then they'll be kind to me. And also, sometimes when you're kind, it makes you happier.
Wow, Ratti, you're such a kind friend. Thanks for chatting with me today. I had a great time.
Thank you.
Bye, friends! Bye!
I love to share.
Sharing is kind. It's why I share something of mine.
I love to share.
Good to give some care and love and you receive.
I love to share.
Come on, man.
Love. I love to share.
Like a
with you. I love to share.
As someone said, one kind word can make them glad.
I love to share.
Good thing I gave.
I love to share.
Thank you.
With you. Sharing with you.
Click the subscribe button below to get new Takalani videos every week.